So a couple of things have happened in the last few weeks that set me off on this little tinkering experiment that I've got sitting here, which I'll explain in a little while. The first thing was I found this old guitar tuner that I built, must have been late 80s, I think, from a magazine article kit. I can't even remember which magazine it was. I want to say it was ETI, maybe Radio Electronics, I'm not sure. Anyway, they called it AccuTune, so that's what I wrote on it with my rub-on lettering. This is one of the first things that I, circuit boards that I ever etched and built. Considering how long ago it was and how young it was, don't judge me too harshly. But there's what's going on inside here. And there's the board that I hand etched. I might have used their layout and done kind of a photo etch kind of a thing. I don't remember. But as you can see, it's got more than a few bodge wires and things in it. Unused pad there for some reason. A couple of places where it looks like I drilled right into the trace rather than pad. That actually may be because I didn't have the right shape of capacitor to fit the pads. I don't know. It ain't pretty, but what do you want? It was one of my first teenage times doing this. So what's on here? The two chips, an LM324, which is an op amp, a quad op amp actually, and this guy, an LM2917, which is a frequency to voltage converter. So essentially, it's originally designed as a tachometer, but if you give it the right level of input, it can be used easily for this purpose. So there you can see it's basically designed as a as an automotive chip, but that's not the only thing you can use it for. So it claims to be fairly linear at the various different frequencies that they tested it, or they tested it at. Within plus or minus 1% between 1 kilohertz and 10 kilohertz. For tuning a guitar, you need it to go down into the couple hundred hertz range, but it seems to be able to do that. And there's basically what's inside it, a couple of different inputs, either on an inverting or non-inverting input of an op amp, through a charge pump, which has its capacitor for timing outside of it. Then yeah, an op amp section with an NPN transistor output. Nothing too carried away inside it. This is kind of the magic here. The charge pump basically creates a voltage proportional to the incoming frequency. And I was surprised to find that these things are actually still available and, well, not ridiculously priced, $2 a piece kind of thing in quantity. That's not too bad. I mean, it's weird that the shipping is, you know, four times more than the cost of the chip, but whatever. So the short answer to how this thing works, audio comes in from the guitar through the jack, goes through a couple of sections of this quad op amp, just to bring it up to a level this thing can work with. Goes out of there through one section of this wafer switch here, this multi-position wafer switch. It's set up in as two different halves. So there's two six-position wiper switches here going on. So the first one takes the amplified signal and runs it out to one of these six pots, which sets the level, because each guitar string is going to have a slightly different level. The higher frequency strings are going to be a little bit lower level. So this sets them all to be about the same frequency, sends it into the tachometer chip, and then it goes out of there. The voltage comes out of there, back through the switch, the other half of the switch again, and then through one of these six potentiometers that lines up with these ones. So this one is the level, and that one is the output voltage. And these guys act as a voltage divider across the regulated voltage here. and basically when you calibrate it so that when the right frequency is happening here, the voltage coming out of there causes a 50% swing on the needle here, and then you can set it for each of the six guitar strings. A little rough and ready, but it sort of does the job. See, that it does the job. It's not perfect because the level of the string tails off quickly. It loses its lock fairly quickly, but yeah, that works. A week or two after I discovered this, or rediscovered this in my accumulation of stuff, I found an interesting video from Look Mum No Computer on YouTube. If you're into tinkering with electronics, and especially analog electronics, and music-related electronics, check this guy out. He's a complete lunatic of the best sort. This is, I love his energy and just the way he just seems to go for it when he's trying a project. Anyway, so he created for his modular synthesizer this performance VCO, voltage controlled oscillator. And basically it is, as the name suggests, it is, you give it a varying voltage and it gives you back a varying frequency in line with that voltage. But he built in this little tuner here, which I thought was intriguing. And he's selling kits of this if you're actually interested in building modular analog synthesizer stuff. But that's not the part that got my attention. This did. The tuner is based on Arduino code. Specifically, this little bit of Arduino. So his modular synth is powered by 12 volts. That's what's coming in here. Creates 5 volts out of the 7805 into the Arduino Nano. Analog 0 is the input from the oscillator. And then he's got some LEDs hanging off the other analog ports. You can use these analog ports as a digital out as well. And so that's what he's doing there. And over here, he's got a 7-segment LED that he's just driving off there. And so I thought with that little piece of circuit, which is, you know, nothing, and maybe a preamplifier to get this voltage up, because a guitar output signal is going to be like neg 30 to neg 40 dBm probably, and his synthesizers are going to be closer to 0 to minus 10 dBm, so I'm going to have to put a bit of a boost in there, I think. But other than that, this and the code that he's got should be able to turn this thing into a bit of a guitar tuner. And here that is on a breadboard. It's pretty much exactly what he had set up on there. I'm being lazy and I'm just using one resistor on the common side of the three LEDs, because those three are never going to be on simultaneously. Only one of them will. And being lazy and a bit naughty, using just a single current limiting resistor on the common cathode of the 7-segment LED. It's not what you should do, it's just what I did, because it was going to get way too cluttered if I did it the other way. And did I mention I'm lazy? So there's that. And this is just a little basic op amp circuit that I knocked together. It's an LM358 op amp, just super basic. It's old school. It's one I happen to have kicking around, so why not? You could use literally any op amp here, because it doesn't have to be audiophile quality. It just has to amplify basically a sine wave, and a relatively low frequency one at that. So I've got it set up with as a non-inverting op amp, and this pot here is the feedback resistor that goes from the output back to the inverting input, that one, and this resistor here, it creates the voltage divider. And then a DC block capacitor on the input and the output, and the filter capacitor for the power, just cuz. So it's completely textbook op amp circuit. Then I just adjusted it so that I would get enough of an output level coming out here into A0 that this thing would reliably trigger and give me a number, or a letter, I guess, in this case. And then the whole thing's just powered off 5 volts from my handy-dandy little power supply over here. Although I suppose technically I could put a battery on there onto the V-in of this, use its regulator to create 5 volts to power that. But I think I'm not going to take it any further than this. This is mostly just because I wanted to see if I can do it. Not so much that I actually needed another tuner. Because, I mean, I've got other tuners already and I got an app on my phone. So this is just playing around, seeing if this could work. You may remember my horrible little guitar from a previous video where everybody told me it was horrible, even though I already knew that. It's grabbing it. It's kind of hard to see that LED. But it is grabbing the notes. This little guitar doesn't want to stay in tune because the strings are so short. But there we go. That's an A, and when it's on, and it's already gone sharp on me again. I don't know whether you can see that. So, it does the job. I mean, if I was to take this any further, probably the best thing I could do with this is create either a compression or an AGC type circuit using the other half of the op amp, because that is a dual op amp, just to hold the level stable as the note dies off, decays basically. But I think this is pretty cool for something that I could slap together fairly quickly just in an evening. And I mean, the code is the code is what it is. It's something that was shared by somebody else and it does the job. But I think this one probably works better for its intended application, where you've got a steady state oscillator and you want to tune to that. Like if you're using this kind of little oscillator and you just wanted to get a specific frequency out of it, this could identify that fairly easily. And that's actually what I was using initially before I built the op amp, just to see if this actually worked at all. And that's kind of that's why I wanted to have this little function generator or frequency generator in the first place. You may recall I built that from a kit many, many months ago. So, like I said, this is just a fun little experiment. I don't really need another guitar tuner. I certainly don't need another home-built guitar tuner. I just wanted to see if I could do this. And it turns out that I'm not the only one that's been down this path. But that Look Mom No Computer video really sort of triggered me on this path. And if you're at all interested in this kind of stuff, I encourage you to go and look at Sam's channel, because he's just a madman, and it's really good stuff that he's putting together. He's thinking outside the box, which, yeah, I mean, he's an artist. That's what artists do. We all kind of should do that once in a while, shouldn't we? Think outside the box. But yeah, so there's I don't know, there that is. I was just tinkering, and I figured I'd bring you guys along today. Thanks for watching. As always, if you got any comments or questions, down in the comment section. Maybe I'll answer them if I know the answer. Maybe somebody smarter than me, especially about the code stuff, will be able to answer. I don't know. Thanks. I'll talk to you later.